Shepherd, therefore can I lack nothing. He shall feed me in a green pasture, and lead me forth beside the waters of comfort. He shall convert my soul, and bring me forth in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff comfort me. Thou shalt prepare a table before me against them that trouble me. Thou hast anointed my head with oil, and my cup shall be full. But thy loving kindness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The lesson is written in the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, in chapter 3, at verse 5. If our injustice serves to bring out God's justice, what are we to say? Is it unjust of God, I speak of him in human terms, to bring retribution upon us? Certainly not. If God were unjust, how could he judge the world? Again, if the truth of God brings him all the greater honour because of my falsehood, why should I any longer be condemned as a sinner? Why not, indeed, do evil that good may come, as some libelously report me as saying? To condemn such people as these is surely no injustice. Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. At this time, when we as the Church have commemorated the presentation of Christ in the temple, when Simeon acclaimed him to be a light to lighten the peoples, let us pray for God's light and his direction. At this time, we pray in particular for those who have been bereaved. Almighty God, look with pity on all who sorrow at this time of loss. Remember them, Lord, in your mercy. Nourish them with patience. Comfort them with a sense of your goodness. Lighten their darkness, and lift up your countenance upon us, and give them your peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.